Like Gruffy the turtle.
Gruffy the turtle. Gruffy the turtle.
Gruffy. I mean, it's Gruffy the octopus, not the turtle.
Gruffy the octopus.
There's another one for a turtle, though. And on the turtle one, I want you guys to try and see if you can come up with a name of the turtle.
I want to name the turtle Crocodile.
What?
I want to name the turtle Crocodile Face.
Yo, that's already a story. That's and we did that one not too long ago. It's called a Golden Egg, and that's the one where the rabbit.
No. The name is the turtle's name is Birdie.
Yes, you guys remember? Oh my goodness, you guys remember? And the rabbit's name was Froggy.
Yes.
And the turtle's name was Birdie. And there was an eagle whose name was?
Crocodile.
And then the beaver was Monkey.
And the beaver was Monkey. You're right. So I think most people heard that one before already. And I think last story we told was the Colossal Squid.
Yeah, I love that one, but I didn't
know it. And just so you guys know, Chivin has a very, 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 very cool book. And the book was involving ninjas. Oh my goodness, I'm going to get some person's camera is like running all over the place. It's going to get me dizzy. And then I'm going to need to eat more of
I'm licking this. The camera.
You need to stop moving your cameras or I'm going to get dizzy and it's going to make me eat more of this. Oh my, they're still moving the camera. Hang on.
Tried to turn off their sound while they're doing that.
You're dizzy.
Okay, we have one more coming in, but it's 9:35.
Okay, shall we start?
Dizzy. Yes, we should start.
Okay, go ahead and pick between the dog. Hey, there he is. That Alex, I think. Alex, yeah. Did you have your pillow and everything? And snacks? You just need snacks, really. Okay, pick between the Blackie, the continuation from Blackie, or Gruffy, the octopus.
Gruffy
the octopus. Okay, did you guys know that octopus can change colors?
Yeah.
The really, really cool thing is they can get up on a rock and they can change their own colors to match the rock. Did you guys know that? And if there's a bigger predator coming near an octopus, the other thing they can do is make themselves look like a snake.
Minna.
They can even walk across the sand like that. They don't have to just swim. They can even walk. And one of the reasons why they walk is so that they don't spook their meal. Meal being a shrimp or a crab or small fish, right? And when I say small fish, that's because we're talking like a medium-sized octopus. Okay, there are octopus that are huge. And guys, guess what?
What?
First of all, I think that Christopher might be the youngest one in this group, is he? Christopher, how old is you? Mr. Christopher.
No. In this group, the youngest is my brother.
Oh, your brother is in there?
Yeah.
All right, fine. In this case, Mr. Chifa.
Yes.
How old is your brother?
3 years old.
No! Are you trying to tell me that we're going to keep this story as PG-3? Lord have mercy. O-M-W. I mean, G. All right, there he is. We're going to keep it PG-3. Okay? But some of you guys should know that the big octopus have beaks. In the middle of all the eight arms. So if you follow the eight arms in, right? You go towards the middle. At the very, very, very center of it are the beaks. And those are his teeth. And they are sharp. And I mean sharp. Okay? They are so sharp that they can crack through clams. What? And hard shell crabs. That's nothing. The hard shell crabs to the octopus, they go like, oh, this is nothing. Doink. That's it. Just that much. And guys, guess what?
What?
One of the octopus's arms are very strong. But then you add the other seven, OMG. They have like tiny, tiny, tiny little bitties, little big suckers on them. But those suckers are a whole bunch on each arm. And okay, tell your brother Chivin to maybe close one of his eyes for this part I'm about to tell.
If you're really scared, close one eye. If you're super
No. If he is halfway scared, then just close one eye.
And then if he's you're really fully scared,
if it's really, yeah, then cover both eyes. Okay, check this out. If an octopus grabs your arms with at least his four arms around yours, you can try to pry it off and you won't be able to. Now imagine if an octopus decided to grab your arm with all of his eight arms. Eight. With the claws, with the beaks in the middle.
Look what he's doing. Do it again.
Eight and the beak. Mmm, tasty. Oh.
Now, he's covering now his eyes. He's covering his eyes.
Yeah, have him cover both of his eyes because I'm going to say one of the scariest parts.
Okay.
Right now. Hey, cover both eyes, please. I'm going to say one of the scariest part, like, right about now. Here it is. The scariest part is, for Sensei, the octopus is delish. Did you guys get it? Did you guys not? Okay, I'll say it again, maybe not as loud this time. I'll get up close to the camera. For Sensei and a whole bunch of islanders, the octopus is delish.
What does delish mean?
You don't know what delish mean? Okay, watch.
It's delicious.
Hey, stop for giving away the punchline. If you need to do a punchline, find the line and punch it to yourself. Huh. Don't do my punchline. Okay, watch. The octopus is... delish.
Totally.
Now that you get it? Did you get it?
Yeah.
It's delish. We're on the frying pan. It's delish on the regular pan. It's the lid on the small pan. It's the lid on the big pan. All of it. Put onions and garlic in it. Wow.
Look at we eat squid and octopus.
Me too.
I'm sorry to tell you guys, but the squid tastes nothing compared to the octopus. The octopus, so much better. So much better. But anyway, guess what? Are you guys ready for another scary part? Okay, yeah. there's gonna be a slight bad news towards the end of this scary part. Okay, guys? All right. There's an old man in those islands where I'm from. He is really good with animals. I mean, people think that this guy is like a Dr. Doolittle. You guys know who Dr. Doolittle is?
No.
Dr. Doolittle is the guy that can communicate with animals. And the guy that I'm talking about in the islands, he might actually be better than Dr. Doolittle himself. You guys don't know who Dr. Doolittle is? What? Sensei Genevieve, you know who Dr. Doolittle is. Is that not a kid's movie?
We actually watched the new one the other day. It was pretty good.
What? I've not seen the new one. Okay. For those who does not know who Dr. Doolittle
is. Has Iron Man in it.
What? Oh my goodness. The movie theaters are going to owe me so much right now. All right. Check out Dr. Doolittle. Okay. Apparently there's a brand new movie.
I don't know how new. Let me check. Not sure when it came out, but I haven't seen it yet.
Well, the fact that I haven't seen it yet either makes it brand new. How much?
But yeah, Robert Downey Jr. It was good.
Yes.
Fun.
Yes. I like him. That guy is the Iron Man guy. How much time do we have?
We're about out.
Oh. Okay, I'll tell you this much. The old man became friends with the octopus. Okay, and that's a story on its own. Okay, but one of the best friendships I've ever known is between that old man, who is very much like Dr. Doolittle, and the octopus, okay? It's a very touching story and very, very nice old man, but there is a very, very, very sad ending to that story, okay? Very sad. I'm trying to debate whether I should tell you that story because just of how sad it is.
How sad is it?
Now, next time when we do story time, you get to decide if you want to hear that sad story or not. All I'm going to tell you is you're probably going to be sad the whole day if you hear this story. And what's weird is that because of that, some of you guys might be like, okay, I want to hear the sad story. And I'll be like, have you lost it? You want to be sad the whole day? Have you lost it?
I do. I want to see the sad story.
See? I rest my case, and I'll leave you with that.
Everything makes me cry, so I don't know if I want to hear this.
Okay, Genevieve, you might have to close one and a half eyes. Look, one full one, and then half of the other one.
Okay.
All right, guys. I hope your snack is still available. I'm going to go find more snacks since mine is gone. And good job on today's class.
Bye, guys.
Bye, guys. Some of them are looking like that story is too short. Bye, guys.
Bye. See you later.
Bye. Bye.